Like clockwork each week, missionaries change from dress shirts and ties into jeans and t-shirts to give much-needed service to a community suffering from the fallout of a COVID-caused lockdown. But during the first few weeks of the pandemic, more than 250 missionaries who left their families from all parts of the world to serve up to 2 years in the California San Jose mission were locked down.
We were stuck inside our apartments, had nothing to do.
The thing that really was the saving grace was them doing humanitarian service projects.
We went to work immediately with partners, and enormously grateful that great partners like Second Harvest Food Bank and the Latter-day Saints stepped up immediately.
We had this opportunity to come out, then we came here and we just started putting produce in boxes.
It has helped tremendously for their spirits, their mental health and well-being to be able to get out and serve.
I love working hard. I try to be the fastest box maker.
Elder Rumble says he may even be the fastest box maker in the West. In fact, it's rumored missionaries hold the record on packing efficiency at the food bank.
We're called a food bank, but really when you look at our warehouses and our fleet of trucks, it's really important to recognize the huge scale we have.
Second Harvest distributes about 12 million pounds of food each month. That's fresh and non-perishable sustenance to about 500,000 people.
Let me make that real. It's about the size of Sacramento.
I've seen it in a different perspective, knowing that there are thousands and thousands of lives that are depending on us.
Now you know that each box that you put out, it's a family. It's someone that you're feeding. You're serving God's children.
Over the past 10 months, missionaries have exceeded 13,000 volunteer hours at Second Harvest, more than any other organization.
I can't even put into words the gratitude we have. There is no way we would have been able to ramp up like this without that consistent support.
And it did a lot of good for the community as a whole. And it did a lot for the missionary. They learned how to mourn with those that mourn and comfort those that stand in need of comfort.
Each week, dozens of trucks leave Second Harvest loaded with food that includes boxes packed by missionary hands. The Portuguese Community Center in San Jose is one of those locations where missionary-packed boxes of groceries are distributed. Prepared meals are delivered to the homebound, and Latter-day Saint missionaries are there to help.
We are giving out food, but also just taking the time to really talk with them, trying to just brighten up their day, spread some positivity when they need it, because it's hard out there.
That example of service is not lost on San Jose's mayor, Sam Licardo.
Hey. Ciao on.
This is the fun part of the job. I love being able to be with people who are so committed to the community and they just want to help. It just raises your spirits.
Those accepting these offerings and perhaps a kind word say it's indeed a blessing when trying to make ends meet in such difficult times.
We don't need to worry. There's food in the house. I have a little son. He's 2 years old. It helps a lot.
This program is I'm here for the first time today. I feel very good when I got the support.
Latter-day Saint missionaries work alongside other dedicated volunteers, and friendships are formed.
We work here like a family. And it gets to a point that there is a big attachment between us.
86-year-old DeCio has manned his post at the PCC throughout the pandemic, except when he was recovering from COVID. He says it's sad when sisters and elders finish their mission and return home.
Let me tell you, we miss them. We really miss them. Fortunately, we have Facebook that we got in touch.
About 30 miles southeast of San Jose, elders and sisters serving in Morgan Hill have filled another important need.
Good job.
Everything's folded. If it's not good enough for my own grandchildren, nobody gets it.
Cecilia, with the help of her husband Gary, has worked hard to serve those in need in her community by offering a food pantry, clothing, and more, 15 programs in all, under the umbrella of the Edward Boss Prado Foundation, a labor of love inspired by her late son.
I have a lot of empathy because I've been there and I know what it's like.
I honor my son every single day. This is what keeps me going.
Necessity born out of the COVID crisis inspired another service, Para los Niños, for the children.
It's free tutoring because these families do not have internet.
To make it work, skilled volunteers were needed.
Missionaries have been coming to us for 6 years, so they jumped right in and they all speak Spanish. That is the beauty of it.
So the kids, their native language is basically English. That's where we come in. We help the parents understand more
English and help the kids understand their homework.
Okay, más tiene, yeah.
We've really seen it helps the family members feel a little bit less stressed. It's definitely taken a burden off of their shoulders.
You know what it is, what is it?
We also started teaching the parents about the internet. Some of them had never been on it. They didn't even know how to turn the power button on.
Diana says she's grateful for the help with her children's homework.
Cuando llego a casa ya tienen la tarea hecha. Me gusta.
Along with tutoring, families are provided lunch.
Thank you.
And given a bag of groceries from the Bishop's Storehouse of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints.
Thank you for coming.
Morgan Hill Mayor Rich Constantine says it warms his heart to see the outpouring of support for those in need in his city.
Hi, Joy. Rich Constantine. Let me give you the elbow there.
As a small city, we don't have the resources, so we have to really rely on our community. And especially the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints helping out Cecilia and other organizations. If we didn't have those organizations, this city would not be thriving the way it is now.
All combined, elders and sisters of the San Jose Mission have volunteered more than 25,000 hours in 10 months. That's more than 3,100 working days.
These hours that they're putting in are not just exclusively for they as a missionary, but they're truly finding themselves to be a fellow citizen in Christ. And that's what's making the biggest difference, I believe, not only in the hearts of the missionary, but also the hearts of the people.
These acts of kindness are not unique to this mission. It's happening in communities all over the world. Right now, dedicated missionaries performing countless hours of service wherever it's needed.